Good morning, students. Welcome back to biology class. Chapter 2, Biological Classification, Part 2. Part 1, we have discussed about the classification, biological classification, based on the cell structure, thallus organization, mode of nutrition, reproduction, phylogenetic relationships. These all are the criteria. R.H. Vittago proposed the five kingdom classification. Name the five kingdom classifications: Kingdom Monera, Kingdom Protista, Kingdom Fungi, Kingdom Plantae, and Kingdom Animalia. Then we discussed about the Kingdom Monera. Kingdom Monera, bacteria are the sole members of the Kingdom Monera. Then we studied the shape of the bacteria. Then based on the shape, classified them. Then it is the habitat classified. They are called the archaebacteria. Extreme salty area, archaebacteria are called halophiles. Hot springs, thermosodophiles. Marshy areas, methanogens. Methane gas, methanogens. They are present in the gut of several animals like cows. Methane gas is producing. Extreme habitat, they are called the archaebacteria. In the normal bacteria are the eubacteria. The example, nostoc, we discussed. There are, depending on the autotrophs, heterotrophs, photosynthetic are there, chemosynthetic are there. What is the meaning of photosynthetic? Photosynthetic means they are in the presence of sunlight, they are synthesizing their own food. Chemosynthetic autotrophs bacteria oxidize various inorganic substances like nitrates, nitrites, ammonia, and they release the energy in the form of the ATP. Then the heterotrophic bacteria are there. They are not synthesizing the food. They are depending on other organisms for their food. Then the cell divisions, they're the how to produce the next generation. They are reproducing by the binary fission, and also they are producing the spores. Then we discussed about the mycoplasma. These are the organisms completely lack the cell wall, and also they are the smallest living cells. They can survive without oxygen. Part 1, we discussed these all the things. Now, the today's class, we are going to discuss the second classification, that is the Kingdom Protista. Okay, all single-celled eukaryotes, true nucleus is present. Eukaryotes means a single-celled unicellular eukaryotic and placed under the protista. The organisms present in the Kingdom Protista are called protists. But the boundaries of this kingdom are not well defined. It may be photosynthetic protista. One biologist may be, they told, they are dividing into different types of the protistas are there. So based on they are classified into the different groups. They are the first one, chrysophyta, dinoflagellates, euglenoids, slimoids, then protozoans. See, listen, chrysophyta, dinoflagellate, euglenoids, slimoid, and protozoans. Members of protista are, they are the aquatic. Aquatic means they are present in the water. The kingdoms form a link with the others, dealing with the plants, animals, and also fungi. It is the connecting link between the plants also, animals also, fungi also. These three characters they are showing the Kingdom Protista. Being eukaryotes, the protistan cell body contains a well-defined nucleus. So it is called eukaryotes, and the other membrane bound the cell organelles. Some have flagella or cilia. Protists reproduce asexually and sexually by a process involving cell fusion and zygote formation. Okay, now we will discuss about the each class. Chrysophytes, first one. This group includes diatoms and golden algae, desmids. These are the examples, diatoms and golden algae, another name desmids. They are found in fresh water and also in the marine environments. These are microscopic, okay, we cannot see through our naked eyes, and float passively in water currents. Most of them are photosynthetic. What is the meaning of photosynthetic? They have prepared their own food. In diatoms, the cell walls form two thin overlapping shells which fit together as in a soap box. See that one? The soap box, you know that one? Down one base is there, then it is the lid is there, cover is there. Same like that, the diatoms are present in the structure, morphological structure, one above the other, like a soap box. The walls are embedded with the silica. See that one? The cell wall is made up with the silica, and thus the walls are incredible. Incredible. The diatoms have left behind large amount of cell wall deposits in their habitat. This accumulation over billions of years referred to as diatomaceous earth. Being gritty, this soil is used in polishing, filtration of oils and syrup. Diatoms are the chief producers in the oceans. They are giving to the producing their food themselves, so they are called the producers. They are the useful also making for the polishing, filtration of the soil, oils and syrups. They are making that one. The second group, it is called the dinoflagellata. Di means two. Two flagellas are present. That is the important point. These organisms are mostly marine and photosynthetic. Marine means present in the seawater, and they are synthesized their own food. They appear different colors. See that one. Yellow, green, brown, blue or red, depending on the main pigments present in their cells. The cell contains the yellow pigment, green pigment, brown, blue or red in color. The cell wall has stiff cellulose plates on their outer surface. Most of them have two flagella. Flagella is the locomotory structure. One lies longitudinally and the other transversely in a furrow between the wall plates, between the two upper and lower, in between one flagella is present. So there are two flagellas, and the one example is a red dinoflagellate. Example is a goniolex, G-O-N-Y-A-U-L-A-X, goniolex, undergo such a rapid multiplication that they make the sea appear red tides. See that one, we can see the some places the color of the water depending on the different colors. Red color, red seed is because of the dinoflagellate goniolex is present. The pigment is present in the cell walls, that is depending, giving the color to the water. Toxins are released by such large numbers. Toxins means they are poisons, may even kill other marine animals such as fishes. They are the, these dinoflagellates are toxic. Okay, the third point, it is the euglenoids. Euglenoids, okay, majority of them are freshwater organisms found in standing water. Instead of the cell wall, they have a protein rich layer called a pellicle which makes their body flexible. Now this is the, they are showing, Euglena is showing the animal character. Normally plant cell have the cell wall, animal cells have the cell membrane. This Euglena cell membrane is called pellicle, which is rich in protein. Normally cell wall is made up with the cellulose, and also they have two flagella, a short and long one. Though they are photosynthetic in the presence of sunlight, when deprived sunlight they behave like heterotrophs. In the presence of sunlight they are synthesized their own food. If their sunlight is absent, they are depending on other organisms, that is called heterotrophs, by predating on other smaller organisms. Interestingly, The pigments of euglenoids are identical to those present in higher plants. Example, euglena. So this euglena showing the animal character and also the plant characters. Okay. The fourth example is slime mold. Fourth classification. Slime molds are saprophytic protista. Saprophytic means they are living on the dead organisms. Dead organisms, the slime molds are living. The body moves along decaying the ticks and leaves, engulfing organic material. They are present in the decayed, decomposed materials. Under suitable condition, they form an aggregation called plasmodium, which may grow and spread over several feet. During unfavorable condition, the plasmodium differentiates and forms fruiting bodies bearing spores at their tips. Spores are the, for the next generation, they are producing the spores. The spores possess true walls. They are extremely resistant and survive for many years. Even under adverse conditions, the spores are dispersed by air currents. So that through the spores, their next generation. Till now, we'll go for that one. Chrysophyta, example is diatoms. Dinoflagellata, example is goniolex. Redder, dinoflagellata. Euglenoids, example is euglena. And slime mold, example is plasmodium. The last classification is protozoans. Proto means first, zoa means animals, first animals. All protozoans are heterotrophs. What is the meaning of heterotroph? They are depending on other organisms for food. They are not the, means plants means they are the autotrophs. It will come, now here it is completely, they are the heterotrophs and leave us predators or the parasites. They are depending on other organisms for completely, they are living on living organism, or they are depending on other organisms for food. They are believed in to be primitive relatives of the animals, first relative of the animals. There are four major groups of protozoans. Important it is, what are the groups of protozoans? First one, it is amoeboid protozoans, amoeba. These organisms live in freshwater, seawater or moist soil. They move and capture their prey by putting on pseudopodia. What is the locomotory structure of amoeba? That is the pseudopodia. Pseudo means false, podia means feet, false feet. And example is endamoeba. Marine forms have silica shells on their surface. Silica is present. Some of them, such as endamoeba, are the parasites. Amoeboid locomotory structure is pseudopodia. Example is endamoeba. Second protozoan classification is flagellated protozoans. The members of this group are free living or parasite. They have a flagella. Flagella is the locomotory structure. The parasitic forms cause diseases such as the sleeping sickness. The example parasite form, it is a flagellated protozoa. Example is trypanosoma, causing the disease name sleeping sickness. Okay. Now, next example classification is ciliated protozoans. These are aquatic, actively moving organisms because of their presence thousands of cilia. Same like flagella, cilia also is an locomotory structure. They have cavity that opens to the outside of the cell surface. The coordinated movement of rows of cilia causes the water laden with food to be steered into the gullet. Example, paramecium. Okay, the paramecium is the example. See that one, amoeba, the locomotory structure is pseudopodia. Flagella, locomotory structure is flagella. Example is trypanosoma, causing the sleeping sickness. Cilia, cilia is ciliated protozoan. Cilia is the locomotory structure. Example is paramecium. The last group, it is the sporozoans. This include the diverse organisms that have an infectious spore-like stage in their life cycle. the most notorious is a plasmodium or the malarial parasite which causes malaria, which has a staggering effect of human population. Sporozoans are the locomotory structure is absent. Like the locomotory structure, spores, they are the spores producing organisms. Spore producing protozoans are the sporozoans, and it is causing the disease malaria, and the causing the disease and the organism's name, it is a plasmodium. Okay, now there the classification one more time: the kingdom protista, chrysophyta, dinoflagellata, euglenoids and slimoids, protozoans. Protozoans, depending on the locomotory structure, again they are divided into the amoeboid protozoans, flagellated protozoans, ciliated protozoans and sporozoans. Sporozoans, spore producing, their locomotory structure is absent, spore producing organisms. Thank you.